Psalm 27, David's Song of Confidence. Here's a good psalm if anyone is needing confidence. A psalm of David. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even mine enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me up upon a rock. And now shall mine head be lifted up above mine enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice. Have mercy also upon me and answer me. When thou saidst, seek ye my face, my heart said unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I seek. Hide not thy face far from me, put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help, leave me not, neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. When my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path because of mine enemies. Deliver me not over unto the will of mine enemies. For false witnesses are risen up against me, and such as breathe out cruelty. I had fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. What a beautiful psalm. Such confidence. The Lord's my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? Amen. If the Lord is for us, who shall be against us? It's all about confidence in God, that no weapon formed against me shall prosper. That's the heritage of the Lord's people who look to him. And that's beautiful. Some of you know that in song form. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord, my God. That's a great song. Won't sing it. Set me upon a rock. We know that Jesus Christ is the rock that the builders have rejected. From Psalm 118, he's become the chief cornerstone. And we will always give sacrifices of joy and praise unto the Lord. Let us always be thankful for what the Lord has done for us. Yes, we all struggle with waiting for sure, but the more you wait on the Lord and over the years, I believe it will become more and more natural for us if we lean upon the Lord. And often faith is in hindsight, right? When you see that the Lord is taking care of you through time and time again, you know that he will do it again. The Lord has never left us nor forsaken us. And I am really moved by Psalm 27 verse 10. This was part of my testimony when we were abandoned at 12 weeks of life, me and my twin brother. So we were forsaken by our father and our mother at 12 weeks of life, but the Lord took us up. So all praise and honor to Jesus. He takes care of the fatherless and the widows. Here's a good verse to memorize. I just love this. I would have fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Let that be your prayer of confidence today, to see the goodness of the Lord. May it be for all of you here in this life. Just wait on the Lord. Be of good courage. He will strengthen your heart. Wait on the Lord.